Hello everybody and welcome back to a brand new video. Today we're back with another market analysis for the month of June. Now the last market analysis I made, I talked about how the economy was deflating. And after the last month, I'd have to say that does look to be true. We just hopped over here onto GE Tracker. We're on the market index page. And we're going to have a look at a few of these indexes first, and then have a look at some of the most popular PVM items, any other interesting market changes. We're going to look at some of the new items. For example, the Mysterious Emblem 10 just came out, and it's kind of interesting how that and the original Mysterious Emblem kind of interact. The price for that is still not settled, but it's kind of all over the place. So anyway, guys, hope you enjoy, and let's get started. Okay, so first up here, let's look at the market index. That one has kind of a bunch of different general items here. Now, if we have a look at the last quarter, things definitely look to be on a downward trend. If we look at the year view, we can see that things really shot up during the summer, kind of continued to be high all the way through until January. And just around January, things really started to drop off quickly. Now, I think part of this could be a yearly trend. We'll have to wait for another 6 months or so to really see if this is kind of just a general trend up and down. So first up here, let's look at some very common PVM items. First up here, we have the Bandos chest plate. If we go back over the last quarter, we can see a pretty steady decline in price. Back in March, around 20 mil ish, currently worth around 18 mil. So it's declined by around 10% more or less. One thing I wanted to look at is the amount bought and sold that drastically different. A little bit maybe, but not much. One thing I'm just noticing right now that's kind of interesting, there seems to be kind of a pattern where one day of the week or one day of the month, the item seems to be traded a lot more, most likely a higher player count, so it's probably Sunday or Saturday or something like that. If we look at the month view, we can kind of see this a little bit more clearly. For example, May 19th was a Sunday. May 23rd was a Thursday. Interesting. May 25th, however, was a Saturday. May 30th was a Thursday. June 2nd was a Thursday. June 5th was a Sunday. Really interesting. So it seems like Thursday and Sunday seem to have either the highest player counts or the highest amount of items traded. Now, the weekly update does come out on Thursday, so that could be boosting player counts, and Sunday is generally the day that most people play. Now, moving on to the Abyssal Whip, another pretty commonly traded PVM item. Down from around 2.8 mil down to 2.5 mil, so about a 10% decrease on that one as well. Now, let's have a look at the Sanguine SD Staff. I personally bought this item a few months ago, which I guess it was a bit of a mistake. I think I bought it for 140 mil and now it's down to pretty close to 100 mil. Now this item has decreased substantially compared to some of these other items. Back in March it was worth around 180 mil, now down to 108 mil. I think a good portion of this could still just be the prices naturally decreasing from raids too. A lot of the hyper rare items from raids aren't as useful as some of the Rage 1 counterparts, like the Sanguine SD Staff isn't that useful. I mean, it is best in slot at Zalra, but the cost per cast is also quite a bit higher. Okay, let's have a look at another God Wars item. We have the Armadil Chain Skirt here. If we have a look at the last quarter, once again, things are decreasing pretty consistently from around 40 mil down to 30 mil on the Armadil Chain Skirt. That actually reduced by a fair margin. Next up here, we have the Abyssal Bludgeon, which is down from around 29 mil all the way down to 26 mil. Again, about a 10% decrease. The Scythe of Vitter has crashed by quite a lot, going from around 1.5 bill down to about 1 bill. Very soon, this is going to be less expensive than the Twisted Bow. And I think this is purely to do with it not being as useful as the Twisted Bow. I think the rarity is probably similar, but the Twisted Bow has so many more uses. Another quick item here, we have the Dragon Plate Body. That's actually decreased in price by a lot as well, going from around 9 mil down to 5 mil. And if we look at the year view, it actually was increasing all the way until around December time. A year ago today, it was worth around 12 mil, peaked at around 20 mil-ish in December, and now is at an all-time low at 6 mil. If we look at the Raids Market Index, again, things have decreased by quite a bit, going from 67 points down to 60 points. So things on average seem to be decreasing by about 10% of their value, at least in the world of PVM items. Now, this is just a random prediction of mine, so don't take my word for it, but I do think in July and August, the prices will start to creep back upwards with generally more players. There's actually a new index on GE Tracker, and that is the Bot Farm Index. Now, when I first looked at this, I kind of thought it would be maybe a rudimentary way to look at the amount of bots that were in the game, is generally when the prices of highly botted items are higher, there are most likely less bots in the game or less people botting it. And to a certain extent, that could be true. However, it does seem to be following that exact same trend line as everything else. So I'd probably chalk it up to more just general deflation than less bots in the game for whatever reason. Still a very similar story. Around the new year, things just started to slowly creep downwards, and it does seem like everything's down around 10 to 20% on average. So yesterday there was actually a new item put into the game, and that was the Mysterious Emblem Tier 10. Now I find this kind of interesting, as it's kind of hard to predict exactly what the price of the Mysterious Emblem 10 would fall at. Now the reason for this is that a tier 10 is actually worth 100 times more than a tier 1 if you take into account bounty hunter points, but clearly that is not how it's being evaluated. It's currently only worth around 2.2 mil or something like that, which is only around 14 or 15 times more that value. What's also kind of interesting to me is the price of the Mysterious Emblem 1 did not actually drop off as much as I thought it would. It did go from 180 down to 160 pretty much in one day, but considering that it doesn't make a lot of sense to buy this item to exchange for bounty hunter points, I'm surprised that it even retained this value. Now I think the only reason that it's still worth 160k is that you need a Mysterious Emblem to upgrade to higher tiers of emblems, which means that if someone doesn't have one they want to do bounty hunter, they still need to buy a tier 1, but I definitely thought it'd be worth less. For example, if you traded in one tier 10 emblem to the bounty hunter store, and you bought, for example, the Lasar Teleport, which is probably one of the highest value items you can get there, you'd be getting on average about 1.5 mil back for your 2.2 mil invested. Now on the flip side, if you bought 2.2 mil worth of Mysterious Emblem 1s, traded them in, you get around 211k back. So it's a really big disparity there. Now that's not to say that everything is decreasing in price. Some items actually are on the rise. A good example here is the Ceridomin Brew, which if we look at the quarter, is actually increasing a fair bit. It's gone from 2800 up to 3500, but man, these Ceridomin Brews are still extremely cheap. This doesn't even really show the full story, but before this they were worth what, like 8 or 9k each? Even 3.5k is still a bit of a bargain. Another item here is a Dragonstone, seems to be rather unaffected by the general market decrease. We have the Raw Shark, which has increased in price by quite a bit over the last month especially, going from around 620 GP each up to around 700-ish. Raw Sharks have been declining for a long time now, so it does actually seem like they may recover in the near future. Another item here is actually Bowstrings. They have nearly doubled in price, I believe, since 3 months ago. Yeah, they're worth around 50 GP back in March, now currently close to 100. Oh my goodness, look at this. This is extremely telling. Back when they were worth 50 GP each, look how many people who were selling Bowstrings. So much so they were down to 50 GP each. That is really interesting. Why was botting Bowstrings so popular back in March? Was that when the Twitch Prime promotion was going on and you could get a free membership maybe? Either way, look how much it's dropped off since then. That is insanely different from like 30 mil, 40 mil a day to like 6 mil, 10 mil. That's 4 or 5 times less Bowstrings that are traded now. And you can see it directly has had an impact on the price, nearly doubling in price over the last couple of months. Kind of a similar story for Raw Sharks. Around 4 mil, 3 mil traded back in March, now down to around 2 mil-ish, not as apparent, but still a significant amount less is being traded in May, June, and we can see that that directly increases the price. That must have been the Twitch Prime promotion, because that is a pretty significant difference. And we have Red Chinchompas, which have been increasing in price over the last couple of months generally. Now just going back to a few more of the highly botted items, looking at Green Dragonhide, back in March, about 2.5 mil traded at peak, and now down to like 1.5 mil. So that really goes to show how much of an impact offering free membership can have on the prices of certain items. Now the price of Green Dragonhide hasn't changed a lot, but we can see exactly how many items, but we can see a drastic difference in the amount of items traded per day. Pretty similar story with a Dragon Bones, worth around 2200 back in March up to around 2500, so it is on the rise. And again, the amount traded going from around 3.8 mil down to like 2.5 mil. So again, a direct correlation between offering free membership and the amount of bots in the game. Not a groundbreaking discovery by any means, but I think it's kind of cool actually seeing visual proof of that concept. I mean, I do understand why Jagex is giving away free membership. I am sure overall is probably good for their bottom line, but it does increase the amount of bots in the game, which does have an impact on the players. So it's something to kind of keep in mind when giving away free membership. All right, now let's have a look at the Twisted Bow. I am so interested in this item now, as well, if you don't know, I'm doing a 1 GP to Twisted Bow flipping series. And well, I guess if it crashes in price a bit, this is just going to make my life a little easier. It has gone from around 1.2 bill down to about 1 bill. So that is also decreasing rather quickly. Now, when we compare this to other items, it has a bit of a different trend. It has not been decreasing since the new year. So I wouldn't really expect it to go under 1 bill, but who knows? Any little bit will help out. So anyway, guys, that is pretty much it. The market does seem to be deflating still. So what does that really mean for you? It could mean that holding on to cash would be a better option than holding on to a bunch of gear, but that's not really practical. So generally, I just wouldn't really worry about it. Things go up and down all the time. So it's better to just have the gear you want. Don't worry about it too much. And if you really want to try to time the market, you can try to wait and sell your gear when it's worth a little bit more. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you next time.